How long we've known each other, Ken? I ever break a promise to you? I will put you in the driver's seat at Le Mans. You just shut your mouth and let me do my thing.
How much fun was shooting this movie and running the cars? And did you actually have the opportunity to run an original GT40?
No, we didn't get to run it. Those things have cost bloody a fortune, you know? Only if Matt had done Avatar would we have been able to afford to
pay for that. What were you doing? Look at that. What are you bloody... Yeah,
no, we didn't get to do that, but we got to drive these replicas, and oh my God, what an adrenaline rush that is, yeah.
I read the production notes, and that said in the Bob Bondurant Racing School that you were the best ever Hollywood driver they had there. Oh. Is that like...
Yeah, but there's that word in there. Hollywood driver. Yes.
Yeah. It's like you and Vin Diesel are the only people who ever went.
But, you know, there's Patrick Dempsey who's done Le Mans a couple of times, which I'm sure you're aware of. Is that something that you would ever consider?
Paul Newman. Didn't he come in second?
I don't even remember his results, but he was quite good.
Yeah, he was good. Steve McQueen, of course. You know, let's just make the whole interview about remembering which actors have driven cars in their lives.
Well, Paul Newman is the obvious one. Tom Cruise drove
Steve McQueen
for quite
some
time. Steve McQueen, quite James Dean.
We're really going to do this, aren't we? Yep. James Dean actually raced against Ken Miles. And Dean came in third. Ken Miles came in first by bloody laps. But then Miles, because he was a cantankerous bastard and he'd done something, actually got disqualified and it bumped James Dean up to second.
Yeah. But is it something you would ever consider to participate in an actual car race?
I think the reality of doing it is that these people tend to start when they're this big. They live and breathe it. It is an extension of who they are. And it's kind of ridiculous to think that at our age, we could start and compete. But could we get to the point where we're actually able to just have an amazing time doing it? Yes, but it would be just for fun. But as a dream, man, what a dream. That is fantastic. You know, what a life. In honesty, if I could do everything all over again, I would love to be a motorcycle racer. I didn't start doing that until late in life.
The pay is worse, I guess.
But that was always my dream. I never dreamed about making films. All I wanted to do was get a dirt bike and just start going on a bike and never stop. And I've always thought that. I went, if I could do it again, I think I'd see what it would be like to really get into motorcycles.
Matt, you've been to the Monaco Grand Prix a couple of times, if I remember correctly. Did you make any friends within the racing community that you could turn to for advice on shooting this movie?
No, I was only there briefly.
He tried to make a lot of friends.
Actually, nobody wanted to hang out with me. I think we had the Ocean's 12 logo on three Jaguars in 2004, and they all blew up. Yeah, but we went and watched him race a bit. Yeah,
yeah. And has any of you ever been to the actual real Le Mans 24 hour race?
No.
We went to Le Mans just to film in the old part of the city. But the track itself is totally different than it was in the 60s. And no, I've never. But I did watch it as a kid. Not the whole thing, but I used to watch Formula One a lot, and then I remember just being in awe, just the look of the cars that were in Le Mans, just like spaceships.
Is it any different shooting a motorsport movie than to be Jason Bourne or Batman or Dick Cheney? Is it different in terms of genre of shooting? I mean, you got to drive some cars, although not a GT40, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, it's every movie's a little different. I mean, this I really saw as a movie about this friendship between these two guys and this really incredible underdog story, you know, that I think people who aren't familiar with racing probably won't be familiar with the story, so it might come as a nice surprise to people. It's incredible what these guys did, the gall to challenge the great Enzo Ferrari, you know, who they revered, and see if they could take him on and to actually do it. It's really a wonderful kind of underdog story.
It's more about the characters, isn't it, rather than about the racing?
Yeah, and that was kind of what it has to be, because it's got to transcend the car racing. You know, hopefully we have a movie with some incredible racing stuff in it, but the takeaway is really about this friendship between these guys.
But it's that friendship and the characters that actually make the races meaningful, that give you a stake as a viewer in the race.
And final one, are there any sports cars in your garages that you particularly like to drive more than other cars?
You imagine that we have big garages with lots of cars in them?
Well, yeah, probably larger than mine.
It's a nice dream, yeah.
I have a Tesla. I think it's fast.
Yeah.
Got a pickup truck.